So, hi everyone, good morning. Today topic is SAP Parallel Accounting System or Parallel Accounting. Very important. My first question is, what is meant by parallel accounting? Everyone, are able to see my screen? Are able to hear my voice?
Yes.
Yeah. And what is meant by parallel accounting? Before going to parallel accounting, I already explained. Once again, I can explain you. Listen careful. If you post any accounting entry or if you post any document entry, that document entry reflection on three currencies. So what is that three currencies? One is
the local currency
and group currency and transactional currency. If you post or when you post any document entry, it will be reflected on three currencies. One is local currency and one is group currency. One is transactional currency. Okay, I already discussed this topic Now, same thing, when you post any document entry, it will be reflected on three ledgers. What is the three ledgers? One is leading ledger and number two is non-leading ledgers. One leading ledger, two non-leading ledgers. Everyone, you just catch the point. When the system or when the SAP has introduced a new GL concept, in this new GL concept, when you post or if you post any document entry, that document entry reflected on three currencies, that is local currency, group currency and transactional currency, and three ledgers, not a general ledger. What is meant by general? GL means general ledger. General ledger nothing but rent, okay, and commission paid, okay, and example land. This is the GLs. What is this? This is the GLs and commission received. This is the GLs, not a ledgers. Ledgers is the different. General ledgers is the difference. GL means general ledger. General ledger means rent, commission paid, land, and commission received, like that. General ledger nothing but whichever general ledger using for day-to-day activity recordings. My question is, what is meant by ledgers? General ledgers is different, ledger is different. Okay, general ledger nothing but rent is one general ledger, commission paid is one general ledger, land is one ledger, commission received is one general ledger. But ledger means what? Ledger means it is consist of leading ledger and non-leading ledger. You just catch the point. For example, this leading ledger and non-leading ledger created by reporting purpose. Leading ledger and non-leading ledger defined by reporting purpose. See this one. Whatever value updated into the leading ledger, that value goes to financial statements automatically. See this one. Once again, I'm telling you, you just catch the point. Okay. If you post any document entry, that document entry value reflected on three currencies and three ledgers. And three ledgers, it is one leading ledger, two non-leading ledgers. Why you are creating non-leading ledger and leading ledger? Just for the reporting purpose. Whatever value updated into the leading ledger, that value goes to financial statement version. And what value? One second, phone. Whatever value updated into the non-leading ledger, just for the reporting purpose. Example, let it be. Let's give example. Everyone, note it down. Everyone, note it down. The heading is leading ledger. Heading is leading ledger. What is meant by leading ledger? Note it down. The leading ledger is based on the same accounting principles. Same accounting principles as that of the consolidated financial statement. So done. Completed. So what is meant by leading ledger? Everyone, can you speak once? Done or not? John, are you there?
John. Yeah. Done,
right? Yeah, listen, means concentrate here. What is meant by leading ledger? Leading ledger depending on the accounting principles. Example, what is meant by IAS?
Indian accounting standards.
Example, Indian accounting standards. The Indian accounting standard for our local accounting principles. Indian local accounting principles. Maybe France is different accounting principles. Okay. And IAS means Indian accounting principles. So this leading ledger depending on the Indian accounting principles. Whatever value updated into the leading ledger, that value goes to financial statements. Like profit and loss account and balance sheet. Okay, and note it down. One more thing, non-leading ledger. Put the heading of non-leading ledger. The non-leading ledger or the non-leading ledgers are parallel ledgers. parallel ledgers. Put as an example, okay. This is example. Example, let's take IAS, Indian Accounting Standard. Okay. The non-leading ledger or parallel ledgers to the leading ledger. To the leading ledger, note it down. To the leading ledger. Done.
So example for the leading ledger IAS, Indian Accounting Standards.
No. Non-leading ledger Dallas. Example, let's take US GAAP and IFRS. Concentrate here. Example, this non-leading ledger for reporting purpose. It may be US GAAP. What is meant by GAAP? General Accounting Accept Principle. Okay. IFRS. What is meant by IFRS? International Financial Reporting Standards. Okay. Listen. Please listen. Okay. For example, this non-leading ledger, you need to create your own based on leading ledger. Okay. This leading ledger SAP already defined, that is called 0L. What is your leading ledger? 0L. SAP already defined. So what is meant by 0L? 0L means local accounting principles. It means as the India IAS, Indian Accounting Standards. So based on local leading ledger, you need to create non-leading ledgers. Example, US GAAP and IFRS. Just for reporting purpose, IAS reporting and US GAAP reporting, IFRS reporting, like that. So based on the 0L leading ledger, you need to create your own non-leading ledgers. Example, US GAAP and IFRS. And you add some points for the non-leading ledger. Yeah, you just add up. You have to activate the non-leading ledger. You have to activate non-leading ledgers. You have to activate non-leading ledgers. You have to activate non-leading ledgers for the individual company codes. For the individual company codes. For individual company codes. Okay. I can conclude here, everyone, you just catch the point here, okay. Listen careful. If you post any accounting entry or document entry, it can be reflected on three currencies. Local currency and group currency, transactional currency. And as well as it can be reflected on three ledgers. One is leading ledger, two non-leading ledgers. And what is meant by leading ledger? This leading ledger SAP already defined this leading ledger. SAP already defined what is that? That is called 0L. So what is meant by 0L? 0L is depending on local accounting principle reporting. 0L means like a leading ledger, or 0L means local accounting principles. Example, IAS, Indian Accounting Standards. Okay, then what is meant by non-leading ledger? Non-leading ledger means based on the leading ledger, SAP already defined 0L. You need to create two non-leading ledger. That can be US GAAP and IFRS. Example. So what is meant by US GAAP and IFRS? Both are just for the reporting purpose. Just for the reporting purpose. Concentrate here. Whatever value updated into the leading ledger, whatever value updated into the 0L, leading ledger, that value goes to financial statements like profit and loss account and balance sheet. Whatever value updated into the non-leading ledger, that will not goes to financial statements, just for the reporting purpose. Like US level, what is my reporting? Example, dollars, what is my reporting? When you take IFRS, different currencies, what is my IFRS reporting? It means IAS reporting, Indian Accounting Standards reporting, and US GAAP reporting, IFRS reporting. When you post one accounting entry, it can be reflected automatically. Anyone, any doubts? Rajkumar, are you there?
Yeah, Venkat.
Any doubts here? Not understand what I'm saying? John, are you there?
Yeah, I'm listening you. Yeah.
Are you understand what is meant by leading ledger and non-leading ledger?
Yeah, the leading ledger is for local purposes and help to prepare the financial statement.
Very good.
And the non-leading ledger is only for the reporting purpose.
Okay, very good, very good. Don't confuse anyone. Leading ledger and non-leading ledger, both are reporting purpose. But whatever value updated into the leading ledger, that value goes to financial statement version. Example, profit and loss account and balance sheet. And whatever value updated into the non-leading ledger, that will not goes to financial statements, just for the reporting. But leading ledger already defined the system. SAP already defined. You don't want to anything. Already a 0L is already defined. Don't do anything actually. I will show you. Okay. So based on 0L, you need to activate or you need to create non-leading ledgers. Leading ledger already created. So based on leading ledger, you need to create a non-leading ledger. Example, US GAAP and IFRS, just for the reporting purpose. When you post accounting entry, the value should be updated. Okay, when you post any accounting entry, rent account data to cash, example. So that rent account data to cash, value updated into both. Okay. Yeah, let's go to configuration. Example, see the first one. The first one, see here. Define ledger for general ledger accounting. The first one, what is this? define ledger for general ledger accounting. So see here, it means we need to define already 0L ledger is there, IAS already 0L ledger is there. Based on 0L ledger, we need to create non-leading ledger, IFRS and US GAAP. Okay, and where I need to define the general ledger, example SPRO, financial accounting new, financial accounting global settings new, and ledger, define ledger for general ledger accounting. So go to SAP, everyone listen careful. So open SAP. Enter username and password. So SPRO, enter SAP reference IMG, select here and financial accounting new and general ledger accounting. Not general ledger, financial accounting global settings and ledgers. This one, define ledger for general ledger accounting. Once again, you just see the path SPRO, financial accounting new and financial accounting global settings new, ledgers, define ledger for general ledger accounting. How to find out the T code? You know very well, right? Additional information, display keys, IMG activities. Okay. And you just double click on this radio button. See here, 0L is already is there. 0L is already is there. Okay. Based on lead, this 0L means leading ledger. This is leading ledger. Okay. And 0L is already is there. So based on 0L, you need to create non-leading ledger. 0L means leading ledger. Already SAP is defined, and you need to create non-leading ledger. Okay. And this is the two digit, and this is the description, and this is the table. What is meant by table? Table means, concentrate here. For example, when you create, do one thing. I will tell you one thing. Some points I can add here. For example, in the SAP, entire SAP, I will do one is configuration in SPRO screen. And creating master data, it will come master data in SAP easy access screen and post accounting entries and same thing SAP Easy Access Screen, then report or reports in SAP Easy Access Screen. Entire SAP you do only 4 activities. One is configuration, later you need to do master data creation, you do accounting entry postings, and you generate reportings. This will do SPRO screen, and these 3 things will do SAP Easy Access screen. Okay, concentrate here. When you do the configuration, or if you create the master data, or if you post accounting entries, both or all are saved as a tables. Saved as a tables means all the data, whatever you do configuration, you do master data creation, you do post accounting entries, all the information saved as a tables in the SAP. So we have separate topic from the tables, very lengthy topic as a tables. So now you just keep it on your mind. What is meant by table? Table means whatever activity you do in the SAP, that activities save as a tables. Okay, it may be configuration, it may be master data creation. Once again, everyone, Sunil has joined. Everyone, listen one second, I will tell you one thing. Now I am explaining what is meant by table. What is meant by table means whatever activity you do in the SAP, that activity saved as a tables. So what it means, when you create leading ledger or non-leading ledger, that information saved in this table. Just keep it on this point, keep it on your mind. We have separate class in the tables. I will explain you later. I am repeating once again. Whatever activity you do in the SAP, that activity saved as a tables. Okay, we have separate class from the tables. I will explain you later. Okay, but in 0L and leading ledger information, non-leading ledger information saved in this table. This table is suggested by the SAP. Okay, Listen careful. This is the leading ledger. Based on the leading ledger, I need to create non-leading ledger. So how to create non-leading ledger? Very simple. Select here 0L and click on copy as. Very simple. 0L is already there. I am creating non-leading ledger. Leading ledger is already there. I am creating non-leading ledger. So select here leading ledger, click on here copy as, enter here any two digit. Example, I am entering here G1. What is meant by G1? G1 means example, any two digit. It may be numerical or it may be alphabets. Okay, and G, I entered, I set is a G1. This is for US GAAP non-leading. So this US GAAP information saved into this table. You just remove from the leading. Why? Because this G1 is the non-leading ledger. That is the reason you remove this tick mark. okay, only zero L ledger have this tick mark because that is leading ledger. And click on your save, enter and save. Press enter button in the keyboard and click on your OK, then save. This one G1 is created. What is meant by G1? G1 means US GAAP, non-leading ledger. This information saved in to this table. Okay, remove this tick mark. Why? Because this is non-leading ledger. One more ledger I can create. Very, very simple. The non-leading ledger creation is very, very simple. How to create? Very simple. Select here 0L and click on here copy as. And set as a any two digit. Example, I am setting G2. G2 is not a mandatory. You can set as a any two digit. Okay, and enter here like IFRS non-leading ledger. This IFRS non-leading ledger saved into this table. Remove this tick mark. Then click on, press enter button in the keyboard, press enter, then OK, then click on your save, then click on your save. Very, very simple. See this one? G1 means US GAAP non-leading ledger, and G2 IFRS non-leading ledger. And 0L leading ledger system already defined. Okay, if you want to create more, you can create, no problem. Okay, but system is allowed one leading ledger and two non-leading ledger. Okay, even sometimes you need to create more non-leading ledgers also. If you required more reports, that is also possible. And now you can create these two for enough for practice purpose. And go back. So this one is completed. The next one. Define currency. See here, this is 0L and here G1 and G2. G2. What is meant by G1 and G2? 0L for leading ledger IAS and G1 for non-leading ledger IFRS. I mean G1 for non-leading ledger IFRS, not IFRS, right? I think US GAAP. And G2 for IFRS. Is this correct? IFRS. 0L leading ledger. G1 non-leading ledger for US GAAP, G2 non-leading ledger for IFRS. Very simple. Okay, next, what is this? Define currency of leading ledger. Very important. See this one. How to define currency of leading ledger. Okay, see here, SPRO, financial accounting new, financial accounting global setting new, ledgers and ledger, define currency of leading ledger. Okay, and go to save and back here, go back, same path, financial accounting new, financial accounting global settings, ledgers, ledger, this one. Define currency of leading ledger. You double click on here. And click on here. New entry. Click on here. New entry. enter here your company code. What is your company code? GM10. GM10. See here. Concentrate here. Means, for example, this 0L and G1 and G2, we are activating for company code level. Okay. And when you click on your company code, you need to activate the currencies. Like, you know, here I clearly mentioned example currency type 30. What is mean by 30? 30 means group currency. At the time of controlling area creation, we have different like 10, 30, 40, 50, 60. Harish, are you remember? You asked me one question. What is meant by 10 and 30? At the time of
area
creation, this is predefined currencies in the ECC. Okay? One second. The first currency means local currency. Second currency, which currency you need to take? Example, group currency 30. And exchange rate type M. What is mean by M? You know, you please remember the my old classes, exchange rate configuration. M means standard transaction at average rate. M. And select here 1. What is mean by 1? What is mean by 1? See here, read 1. This is the 1 and 2 standard one actually. Translation taking transaction currency as a basis. Okay. Then click on your OK 1. And here you need to take 3. 3 means, see this one. Concentrate here. If you post any accounting entry or if you post any document entry, there is a 3 dates. What is 3 date? One is document date, one is posting date, one is translation date or transaction date. So what is meant by document date? See here. What is meant by document date? What is meant by document date? For example, whatever date available into physical document. For example, I am posting vendor invoice. Whatever date available into the vendor invoice, that date is called document date. Okay, that date is called document date. And what is meant by document posting date? Example, once again, I am repeating. Document date is, example, I am posting vendor invoice. Whatever date available into vendor invoice, physical document date, vendor invoice, that date is called document date. Example, that date 01 and 0, example, what is 9, 2020. What date available into the document, or what date available on document? 01 09 2020. This vendor invoice I am posting 05 09 2020. This vendor invoice document I am posting into the system 05 and 09 2020. That is called posting date. This document I am posting into the SAP system, example 05 09 2020, that is called posting date. And what is mean by translation date or transaction date? Transaction date same as a posting date. Okay, means this currency need to update, example translation date or posting date, then press enter. Click on your save. C see here, this INR automatically updated. Why this automatically updated means this INR I specified at the time of company code creation. So based on the company code creation, this information automatically updated. So you need to specify second currencies. If you required third currency, but practicing purpose this is not required, okay? And if you required, I will tell you later. So this is the first currency, this is the second currency. First currency means company code currency. At the time of company code creation, we are specified. Second currency, you need to select any currency. For example, any currency like group currency, hard currency, indexed based currency, global currency. If you want to select company code currency also, no problem. But I am selecting group currency. So when I selecting your group currency, this USD came automatically. Why means the T code SCC4. T code SCC4. I maintained my group currency is USD. I already explained. T code SCC4. This is the T code, transactional code. T code SCC4. I maintained my group currency is the USD. That is the reason when I take 30 here, this USD came automatically. So click on your save and back. The next one. Define and activate non-leading ledger. Define and activate non-leading ledger. So what is meant by define and activate non-leading ledger? I will explain. So same path, like financial accounting new, financial accounting global settings, ledgers and ledger. Define and activate non-leading ledger. You just double click on here. See here, what is this? This is called, here you need to specify non-leading ledger. For example, see here, when I enter here 0L, what is meant by 0L? Leading ledger, okay? When I enter here leading ledger, click on here, okay? Okay, it is asking non-leading ledger. For example, do one thing. What is our non-leading ledger? G1. Press enter and click on your new entry. So what need to understand here? This is for non-leading ledger. Okay. And click on here this. Enter here G1 and G2. I created G1 and G2. G1 for non-leading ledger for US GAAP. G2 non-leading ledger for IFRS. Okay, enter here G1, click on here OK. Then click on your new entry. Then enter your company code GM10. Why I want to assign this G1 to company code? It means this G1 is belongs to company code GM10. That is the reason I am specifying. This G1 non-leading ledger is belongs to company code GM10. And here you need to select 30 is a group currency we already maintained. And fiscal year, which fiscal year you need to select here? We are specified G3, April to March, 4 special periods. Then variant, posting period variant. We already created one variant. See here. GMPV, GM posting period variant. and why I want to create these things, then press enter. And click on your yes. Select your GM10, press enter. Better you click on your no. See here, concentrate here. Why I want to enter this fiscal year variant, this posting period variant, and this company code? It means this GM works in this company code. This GM belongs to this company code. This GM1 non-leading ledger. This non-leading ledger belongs to this fiscal year. This non-leading ledger belongs to this posting period variant. We are mapping. This non-leading ledger belongs to which company code? This non-leading ledger belongs to which financial year? This non-leading ledger belongs to which posting period variant? We are mapping. Okay. Then one more company code we have, GM20, okay, and same as 30, and G3 and GMPV. Press enter. Once again, well, it is not accepting 30. Click on your save and back, and click on your one more thing, and G2, press OK. Click on your new entry. G2 means non-leading ledger, GM10 and 30 currency, and fiscal year G3 and GMPV. Press enter. Then click on your no, then save and back. Same way you need to assign GM20 also. Double click on your GM10, then click on your new entry, GM20, 30. Is not permitted. Why? Yeah. You just assign GM10, GM20 we will check you later, okay? Then click on your save and back. Very, very simple. Why you are doing this step means we are created G1 and G2. Why you are doing this step means this G1 and G2 belongs to which company code? This G1 and G2 belongs to which financial year? this G1 and G2 belongs to which posting period variant. We are mapping the system. We are mapping the system. This is the non-leading ledger. Comes belongs to this company code, like that. We are mapping the information. Okay, that is the reason we are doing to this step. Define non-leading ledger. Define and activate non-leading ledger. That is the reason we did this step. Anyone, any doubts here? The next one, assign scenarios and customer fields to ledger. Assign scenarios and customer fields to ledger. See here, we have 0L and we have G1 and G2. It means, what is the step? Assign scenarios and customer fields to ledger. It means, whatever fields available into the 0L, whatever fields available into 0L, same fields you need to copy paste to the G1 and G2. So what need to understand, whatever fields available into the non-leading ledger, you need to copy paste to non-leading ledgers also. Whatever fields available into the leading ledger, you need to copy paste non-leading ledgers also. So that is, so leading ledger is system predefined. One second please, give me some time. Yeah, and assign scenarios and customer fields to ledger. So go to same path, financial accounting, new financial accounting global settings, ledgers and ledger, assign scenarios and customer fields to the ledger. You just double click on here. And see here, there is an 0L and there is an G1 and there is an G2. So what need to understand, what, see here, scenarios and customer fields. Okay, whatever scenarios and customer fields, whatever scenarios and customer fields available into the leading ledger, same scenario, same customer fields, you need to copy paste to the G1 and G2 non-leading ledgers. Okay, very simple, you just concentrate here. Select here 0L, double click on scenarios. See here, this is the fields available into 0L. This is the fields available into 0L. So these fields you need to copy paste to non-leading ledger. Okay, press control Y. See here, press control Y, the cursor will change like this. You need to select scenarios and control C, then go back, select here G1, double click on scenarios, then click on your new entry, then paste here, press enter and save. See here and go back and click on your G2, double click on scenario, click on your new entry, paste here, press enter. Yes, please go ahead. Speak loud. Okay, I can repeat. Okay, see this one. Concentrate here. See here. Go up, go up. This 0L is system defined this 0L, right? Listen carefully. This leading ledger is created by the system. Already SAP is defined this leading ledger, okay? And we created non-leading ledger our own. We created non-leading ledger our own. So leading ledger is accepted some fields, like example, which fields? Like example, see scenarios like segmenting reporting, cost center updating, and preparation, consolidation, and business area, profit center, segment, cost of sale accounting. This scenario accepted by the 0L. Okay. So based on the 0L, we have created G1 and G2. Based on 0L, we created G1 and G2 for non-leading ledger. This is the non-leading ledger. So how the system will understand? It means whatever scenario available into the leading ledger, same scenarios you need to copy paste non-leading ledger. That is called G1 and G2. Okay, why? Because 0L leading ledger system defined information. That system defined information you need to paste for your ledgers G1 and G2. Got it? Got it my point?
Yes.
Save and back. So G1, we copy paste it. See, segment reporting, cost center and all. And G2, copy paste it. Very simple. How to copy paste? Very simple. Select here G0L and click on here scenarios. Then control Y, select. Okay. And control C. Select and control C, copy, go back and select here your G1 and G2, click on your scenario, then click on your new entry, press control V, control C is the copy, control V is the paste, click on your new entry, then cursor point here, control V, it is going to paste it here, then go back, 0L. So no customer fields is available. So see this one customer field is available. Once again, you just listen how to copy paste. Select here 0L, double click on customer fields and control Y, press control Y, our field select, control C and go back, click on your G1 and double click on customer fields, new entry, then paste it here, press enter, save, then go back and select here G2, double click on customer fields, new entry, then paste it here, control V, paste. The next one, assign scenario. This one is completed. Activate cost of sales accounting. Activate cost of sales accounting. Activate cost of sales accounting, same path, SPRO, financial accounting new, financial accounting global setting, ledger and activate cost of sale accounting. Ledger, this one, same path, activate cost of sales accounting. You just double click on this, activate cost of sales accounting. See this one, and click on here, give position, enter here your company code GM10, press enter. Now this is an inactive mode. This is an inactive mode. Now you need to activate. Activate, then activate. Press enter and save. Then go back. Simply you need to activate your company course. You need to activate your company course. Save and back. And see this one. Define ledger groups. This step basically optional. You can create or you cannot create as your wish. These steps belongs to optional. This is also just reporting purpose. So you can create or not, you can configure or not configure, that is up to you. This step is belongs to optional. The next one, define accounting principle. Define accounting principle. What is my accounting principle? And local GAAP, IFRS and US GAAP. Local GAAP and IFRS and US GAAP. You need to define this. Define accounting principles. Okay. SPRO, financial accounting new. SPRO, financial accounting new. Financial accounting global settings. Ledger, parallel accounting. Define accounting principles. Very simple. So what is meant by accounting principle? In as per my system, we are created local GAAP for IAS, IFRS and US GAAP. You need to define this. Okay. And same path. Example, I am going through path once again for your understanding purpose. So SPRO, enter. SAP reference IMG, select here, financial accounting new, financial accounting global settings, ledgers and parallel accounting. Now we create, previously we created ledgers, now you need to go to parallel accounting, this one. Define accounting principles, financial accounting and financial accounting global settings, ledgers and parallel accounting. Define accounting principles. You just double click on this and click on your new entry. Enter here up to 4-digit accounting principle. Enter here up to 4-digit. Example, GMLG. What is meant by GMLG? GM local GAAP means IAS. Example, IAS, Indian Accounting Standards. And GMUG. What is meant by GMUG? Enter here any 4-digit identification. GMUS GAAP. Okay, and GM IFRS. Press enter and save. The last one, assign accounting principle to ledger groups. The last step, same. Next one, assign accounting principle to ledger groups. Click on your new entry. What is my accounting principles? First one is I created, see here. GM LG, GM local gap. See this one. The last step you need to assign, like, you know, accounting principle to target group ledger. So example, I created GM local gap. GM local gap means leading ledger. What is my target? 0L. 0L is my target. And US gap. Example, let's take US gap. GM US gap. For US gap purpose, I created G1. Where is G1? See here, G1. Non-US gap, US gap non-leading ledger. And last one is GM IFRS. Where is GM IFRS? GM IFRS. And this is for G2. IFRS, non-leading ledger. So what is your accounting principle? What is your target ledger? Local gap, 0L. US gap, G1. IFRS, G2. This one we created. I will tell you one thing. Don't confuse here. Why you are doing these steps? These steps we are doing just for the reporting purpose. When you post accounting entry, the value should be updated, leading ledger and non-leading ledger. Leading ledger already is there in the system. Okay. Based on the leading ledger, we need to create non-leading ledger. So simply whatever information available into the leading ledger, you need to copy paste to non-leading ledgers. Okay, very simple. Why you want to do leading ledger and non-leading ledger? If you post any accounting information, value should be updated, leading ledger and non-leading ledgers, just for the reporting purpose. IAS, IFRS, US gaps, reportings. So later we can post n number of accounting entries, upcoming classes, then again we can discuss for parallel accounting. Why created this, why created that, so different things we can discuss. Okay everyone.